The federal government has pledged a major crackdown on illegal tobacco, committing almost $190 million for Border Force and Federal Police to target smuggling operations. It comes as a criminal turf war continues to rage in Melbourne over the control of black market tobacco.
Another tobacco shop up in smoke. The latest in a series of suspected arson attacks in Melbourne.
Explosions and the whole shop took off.
It was scary and loud.
They're like exploding grenades, bullet bombs.
Right now there is a war for control of the illegal tobacco and illegal vaping market, and it's taking place in our suburban shopping strips.
Outlaw bikie groups in a violent wrestle with criminal syndicates over lucrative illicit trade.
Organised crime gangs are using illegal cigarettes, tobacco and vapes as an ATM to fund their activities like sex trafficking and drug trafficking.
The government's taken their foot off the pedal, and you've allowed over the course of the last 18 months for these organised crime groups to really take hold.
Imported illegal tobacco, both loose leaf and black market cigarettes, also burning a big hole in the federal budget.
The market in illegal cigarettes and illegal tobacco costs taxpayers more than $2 billion, maybe as much as $3 billion every single year.
Australian smokers are among the world's highest taxed. Tobacco excise, a massive revenue source for the federal purse. More than $55 billion to be collected from smokers over the next 4 years, far outstripping other so-called sin taxes on beer and spirits. By comparison, petrol excise will collect $30 billion over the same period. Border Force and the Australian Federal Police will receive almost $190 million to target tobacco smugglers.
To shut down this illegal trafficking at its source, it will help boost interception activities at the border by ABF.
The paradox with tobacco tax is that while it's increased every year to discourage smokers, the government increasingly becomes addicted to the revenue it generates. Andrew Probyn, 9 News.